Hi, in this video, we are going to talk about how to install Python 3.10.2 on Windows 10, and also we are going to talk about a couple of notes that you should really care about. First of all, you should open a browser, let's say Google Chrome, and in the Google, you should type Python website, and you should press enter. And you can see here is the Python website, so you should click on it. And here is the official website of Python programming language. You should click on downloads. And now you should scroll down, and here you can see Python 3.10.2. So you should click on it, and here you should scroll down, and here you can see the files. So because I have a 64-bit Windows, I should click on this link. But if you have a 32-bit Windows, you should click on this link. As I said, I have a 64-bit Windows, so I click on this link. And I should wait for the download process. So you can see the file has been downloaded, so I click on it. So in this step, first of all, you should check this one, add Python 3.10 to path, which is a very, very important step. So you should check this one, and then you should click on customize installation because you want to customize the installation process. And in this window, optional features, remember to check all of these. For example, pip is used for installing the modules. So remember that you should check all of these. Then you should click on next. And in this step, you should choose the install location, which is very important because the interpreter of Python programming language is going to be installed in this location. And you need to know the path of that interpreter. So, for example, I want to choose a location like this, and I click on the install, and I should wait for the installation process.
Clicking on the like button really helps out the channel with the YouTube algorithm, so I would really appreciate it if you did.
So as you can see, the setup was successful, so I click on close. So if I go to the location which I have chosen for the installation of Python, you can see here is a file, python.exe, which is the interpreter of Python programming language, which is a very important file. But maybe you ask, why is it important? Because for example, if you want to install an IDE, let's say like PyCharm, which is a famous IDE for Python programming language, you need to know the path of the interpreter of Python. So you should remember this location. And in order to check whether we have installed Python correctly in the search of Windows, you should simply type cmd, and you can see command prompt. You should click on it. And here you simply type Python dash dash version, and you should press enter. And you can see Python 3.10.2 has been installed correctly. And also maybe you want to check the pip version. In order to do so, you should simply type py space dash m space pip and dash dash version, and you should press enter. And you can see here is the version of pip. And also you can use this environment in order to write Python codes. For example, if you type Python and if you press enter, you can see here you can type whatever you want. For example, let's print something, let's print hello world. And if I press enter, you can see here is the output. But also there is a better place in order to write Python codes. In the search of Windows, you should type IDLE. And you can see here IDLE Python 3.10. You should click on it. And here is the IDLE. And I want to increase the font. So I go to options and I click on this one. And for example, I want to change the font to 20. And I press OK. And you can see the font has been increased. So for example, I want to print something. I want to print hello world. So I simply type print hello world. And I press enter. You can see here is the output. And if you want to see the list of modules that have been installed on Python by default, you can simply type help and you should pass modules and you should press enter and you should wait a minute. And you can see here is the list of the modules that have been installed on Python by default. But to be honest, the auto-completion and features of the Python default environments are not good. So I suggest you install a good IDE, which stands for the Integrated Development Environment, like PyCharm, my favorite IDE, and it's free. And if you want to install PyCharm IDE, you can click on this tutorial, which is on the screen now.